Joining us here today from CUFI is Pastor Victor Sturski. He is Eastern Regional Coordinator for CUFI, an author, a longtime pro-Israel activist, and a frequent speaker at religious and advocacy organizations and college campuses across the nation. Please join me in welcoming Pastor Sturski.
Thank you so much. On November 12, 1939, just 2 days after Kristallnacht, and while cities throughout Germany, Austria, Czechoslovakia were still smoldering, more than 100 Nazis were gathered for a meeting on the Jewish question. It was hosted by Hitler's right-hand man, Hermann Göring. Three decisions were made at the meeting concerning the violence and the destruction committed during the night of Kristall. First of all, the Jews would be held responsible for the pogrom and ordered to clean up the city and make repairs. Secondly, the massive payments owed by insurance companies to Jewish property owners would not be collected by the Jews, but confiscated by the Nazi state. And lastly, the Jewish communities would be forced to pay a penalty of 1 billion German marks for instigating the unrest of Kristallnacht. And today, we see the exact same wicked and absurd accusations being leveled at the Jewish people. Just 4 days ago, on November 10th, exactly 77 years to the day of Kristallnacht, the European Union announced decisions they had made regarding the Jewish question and the Palestinian pogroms taking place throughout Israel, and the EU has determined that Jews are responsible for the uprising. And the Jewish nation of Israel should be financially penalized for instigating the unrest, as Senator Rubio mentioned, through the EU's forced labeling and, in effect, boycotting of Israeli products from Judea and Samaria. The madness continues. Joining and leading the European Union are certain Christian denominations whose voices are also demanding boycotts against the Jewish nation of Israel. These Christian brothers and sisters of mine speaking out against Israel today are the direct ideological descendants of yesterday's Christians whose voices were silent and whose doors were closed to the plight of the Jews during the Shoah. And so tragically, throughout history, it's most often been the carriers of the Christian flag who were the fiercest enemies of the Jewish people. Benjamin Disraeli, the only Jewish prime minister Great Britain ever had, sums up the history of the Jew and Christian very well, and I quote him. He says, "The Jews are a nervous people, a nervous people. 1900 years of Christian love has taken a toll on us." I understand that the living cannot really forgive on behalf of the dead, but this evening, on behalf of the now 2.5 million members of Christians United for Israel, we ask God, and we ask you, our Jewish brothers and sisters, to please forgive us for the sins of our fathers. There's no restitution we can bring. How could there be? Nor can we change the past. But there are millions of us who are doing everything we can with the rest and the best of our lives in building a new future with you. And we make you this promise. Never again will the Jewish people stand alone. Never again will you say there is no one for you. Our commitment to you is not guilt-driven. It's not based upon a heretical end of days theology, nor is it a hypocritical smokescreen of affection while secretly scheming to turn you all into Christians. Listen to me. I've been a pastor for over 30 years. Believe me when I say most of us are doing our best to try and turn Christians into Christians these days. Our ratio of meshuggahness is insane and humiliating, and you know it. But millions of us are literally working day and night in our homes and in our churches to assure you the next 100 years of support as we teach our children and our children's children that the Jewish people are a light to the Goyim. You are the beloved of God. You are the apple of his eye. In the last 90 days, Christians United for Israel, CUFI, has grown by over 210,000 new members. And through our CUFI on campus chapters, we are now working on over 300 universities, reaching thousands of students across the nation, equipping them to battle BDS, anti-Semitism, and teaching them how to fearlessly advocate for Israel on their campuses and on Capitol Hill. Baruch Hashem, as we say. I end with this. Today's pro-Israel Christians are linked in name only with the anti-Semitic Christians of the past and the present. For we are of the lineage of Ruth, the Moabitess. And on behalf of CUFI, I beseech you today with the words that Ruth spoke to Naomi, please, don't ask us to leave your side. Don't push us away from standing with you, for wherever you go, we will go, and wherever you stay, we will stay, and your people will be our people, and your God will be our God, and where you die, we will die. We'll be buried together. You are not alone. I'm Israel. Ha!